Again, with this assembly right here, attaches to this wing, is the same way these go on. Right here, you got your little location tabs right here. Look like little footballs or a host of Twinkies, whether they are. Oval shape, like a capsule. You got two tabs right here. And they fit only one way they fit. That's this way. Okay, guys. We'll get this in there right now. So, well, this little glue right here, if you will get in there. Put a dab right there, then a dab there. There you go. Now, you gotta pick up the structure and make sure you know it's in there. There. There's one good, put a little more glue in there to reinforce the bond. You don't want this thing to fall out once you get this wing closed up. It's always best to put a little more glue in there than what it needs. Make sure that bad boy's in there. But like I say, all it takes that thing to fall off and all your work is ruined. Got it the wrong way. I'll be doggone. Old boats is old Frankie's tired. And we're gonna get this thing right. Like I say, make sure by here, guys, it fits outward. There we go, fits real good. Man, right in the first place. That'd be doggone. There it is. Well, why that's set right there. I don't know what I'm fighting this thing for. Maybe I'm just tired, guys. But still got it to go. I still got it going right here. No big deal. I feel pretty good now. That just fits right there, just like that. Like I say, guys, you got those locating tabs there. That's only one way this thing to go. Is the locating tabs. What the devil is this? The hell? Boy, I am tired. Gotta excuse me, guys. I made a mistake here. This goes right like that. Simple fix. I knew there wasn't something right a while ago. There you go, guys, like nothing ever happened. Put a little more glue in there. That thing will sit just like nice and pretty. There it is. Okay, guys. Next is going to be the the wing panels. Right here on the instructions right here, it shows you how your outer wing panels will fit on here. So on the construction of this, how they got it right here, is it's like a tongue. You got a tongue groove. That wing will fit right over. When you flip it over on top like this, that wing will fit flush on there, like on this lip right here. And this actually reinforces for your outer wing panels. Okay guys, we got this whole thing done here. It looks pretty good. Just follow the instructions, you guys can't go wrong. I may have flipped up a while ago because I got overzealous. That fit looks good. Make sure that thing's in there real well. You sure shoot, don't want this thing to fall out on you while you're closing up the wing. Okay guys, next I'll fix this right now. I got this little ring in Tamiya glue right here, guys. It comes off your handle here, it goes inside here. I'll think about my pile of glue right there and put it in there, it may stick. And I like that in there because it seals your glue. Because you want this stuff to vapor. One thing about liquid glue, it'll vaporize real good, be careful. Okay, got that problem fixed. Problems. Okay, I'm digging in the box now for the screw for the outer wing panels, and there they are right there. Remove these wing panels from the sprue. Yep, Airfix is going to retool that new vocal bummer they got. That's going to be a treat right there. Alright. Come back over here and trim this wing. Sure, it's good and clean. And get that shit shaped. Well, I'll tell you one thing, guys. I'm sure glad I got that cutting sock done. It's unbelievable. It took me 58 years to finish something like that. It could take you 3 months. Well, fellas, like I say, guys, we all got the same kind of disease, which ain't a sin. That's called model syndrome. You got bored building one model, you want to go on to something else. But pretty soon you got a bunch of unfinished builds laying around, and eventually they get broken. And when that happens, you get mad. So I get to them, guys. It takes me a while, but I get to them. Right now, I got a lot on my belt right now, and I want to get myself lost in a production line full of unfinished kits. But if you got a hell of a stash pile like I got, they all call them on you. And it's hard to resist. Maybe it's good to do that because you always go back and work on some more and go on something else, and it kind of keeps you interested. Huh. I've never looked at it that way before. That may be the possibility. But I do know one thing. I'm sure loving this Airfix kit right here, this Vulcan bomber. I think I said it a couple of times before, and I'll say it again. This thing is one mean-looking machine. There's something about it. This thing is wicked-looking. See something like this creep up on you like that? Scare the hell out of you. But I always loved the design of English aircraft. There's something about them. They got a beautiful... Their line's just right. Okay, got one more to go, fellas. Like I say, in Espanol, and what's the key? One more here. Get that off there. Make sure this thing's clean. Like I said before, guys, you'd be surprised. With your hands are almost like eyeballs. What you can't see, you can feel. What you can feel is there. And once you sand it down like this, it ain't longer there no more. Okay, guys, that's it. Ready to join these wing panels together. Okay, guys, the top of here. Well, they got static lines on both top of the wing, don't they? I guess this is the top section. I think the top section has static lines. It does. Boy, this thing's a big wingspan, this bad boy. Okay, guys. Gives you a good idea right here. On the size of this thing. This is the other pan, like I say, fits right here just like this. It's big. This thing is big, mean, scary, and beautiful. Yeah, I like the way they incorporated the wing panels. Because you don't need no filler here, guys. I don't see no filler at all. None at all. That is superb all the way. Now, I like that. Has a nice, good fit right there, guys. And you got this beautiful looking tongue groove wing spar. The outer wing panel for it to fit good. And I can see why they engineered that too, to keep this thing pretty well strong. Yep. Check the other wing. Okay, guys, when you're only fits one way, guys. On your stack, on your static lines right here where they are, they fit veins or whatever they are. Fits on top of the wing like this, guys. Only fits one way. So it goes on the top of the wing. And the smooth portion of the outer wing panel fits at the bottom. Okay, right now, we're going to join the top wing panels of this thing. One thing about Tamiya glue, guys, like all liquid glues, are they evaporate real fast, so you got to work real quick. You gotta put a lot of cement on there for it to work. Okay, guys, it fits about like this. just like that. There you go, guys. Got the outer panel on there. It fits perfect. The fit is perfect. Now what you want to do is come back and make sure you got enough cement on the spar where it fits. It's just reinforced the cement. Okay, come over here, do the same thing on the starboard side. Okay, let this thing dry for a couple of minutes. Take a little bit of break right here. I don't know how long this video is going to go on, guys. I farted around with the camera. It has a time lapse on it. I don't know what that means. Recording time lapse. 24 hours, I guess. I don't know, something like that. So we're going to see how this goes. So I want to try to do it. I'm trying to avoid not making 5-6 videos on one video. So I like to hope this thing all contains down to one video. And so do tell. Okay, I'm about ready to knock off here. What I'm gonna do, guys, and we'll talk Frankie Day's a little tired, and we'll take this bill tomorrow night. And I'm gonna go ahead and glue the bottom sections of the out of wing panels to complete the wing, and see what else. See if I can go into the center section too before I close up the video. I got other steps to go before I close up that wing, but I will add the two bottom wing out of wing panel halves, and I will call it the video. Okay, guys. I'm out of the ball, you know, with these kit models. I got about three shaken down so far. I got the Isabella, I got the Victor, I got the Gorgebook, and I got Mr. Martin Lambert's Messerschmitt 410, and he's ready for some priming or tonight, which I'm going to primer. Incidentally, why I'm priming the 410 tonight, I'm going to go ahead and prime these parts I previously done in the first video. The construction of the pilot's compartment, and also the nose wheel well. Make sure they're good and primed. And they'll be receiving some paint jobs too, once they get the fuselage. Okay, guys. So all there is to do with this thing is, as you can see, it's big. And it's heavy too. I can see why they put that spar in there too. That's a lot of weight. That's funny, this thing got pretty heavy after adding those two wing panels. So I'm going to go ahead and close out wing panels up and call it a vid. And tomorrow we shall proceed.